And we're back at the Mostra Dolce Mare diving pool in Naples, where we are on our second day of diving finals at the 30th Universiade. I'm Chris Snowd, and we'll be taking you through the next event, the men's synchronized 10 meter final. 9 teams. We got one. Our final pair in round one. That's the Chinese. Another in the dive pipe. Wow, beautiful pikes from both of them. I still think it could have been a better entry. It just didn't get that sound effect. But look at those pikes, synchronization spot on. I think we get used to seeing the Chinese with splashless entry, and if there's even a little bit there, we start to get critical. But both beautiful inward dive pipes from the pair of them. Surely that'll go over 50 points. And it does, 54. And we're hearing lots of nines. I don't know where the 7.5 came from on the execution. It was a brilliant inward dive. So we're getting very close to tens with those 9.5s, and we're only on the first round. Mexico, excellent in the first round. Currently in second. This dive, a back dive pike. Yeah, good back dive from both of them. Belisa Isaias, just a little short of vertical. And there's the reach back. Just need to pull the dive around a little bit more. Synchronization is good at this point. Reaching back at the same time together. And here we see the swing off the board. Reach, touch, slide, hold, reach back. They could have just held that position like a bullet diving towards the water before reaching back. Well, they were in second at 47 points, takes them below 50. They should be safe with that position, at least in the top three. Good opportunity for the Canadians in six. Both nailed it. Pittman with a lovely entry. Dustin Paredes also with a nice entry, but it was the start. Gave them lots of time to finish dives. Fast spin, good bounce off the ball. Piking out from about 5.5 meters. There's the pike out, check the rotation. And pretty good entry from both of them. Not sure it'll be enough to get into the 70s, but it's gonna be close to it. And it is 76.80. So at the moment, I'm looking down on the scores. That has tied China's in with 3.5 in the third round. So joint highest score. China in second. Chance to go ahead of the Mexicans. We've got 65 on their dive. This, a reverse 3.5 somersaults tuck. Oh, fantastic dive. That is the dive of the competition so far. They took off, they spun, they kicked out at 7.5 meters, reached back and just disappeared. It's like, where did the Chinese go? There's the kick, there's the lockout, and just sucking all the water down to the bottom of the pool. Brilliant reverse 3.5s. Double at board level, triple at 7 meters, kicking out at 7.5 meters. 90.78, that completely dwarfs anything that we've seen before. Russians dropped back from third into fourth and now are currently in fifth at 3.5. Yeah, it's good. Well, they needed that. They were 6 points behind third place going into this round. So the 6 points behind Canada. Canada has got a 62. There's the kick, reaching back. Pretty sure on that out. And they attack the start, finishing nice and high. Good tuck. Very compact there. There's the sharp kick out, the reach back, nailing it. So I reckon they're going to go ahead of Canada. 80.19. So the second highest score. And that's moved them at the moment into second place. So they have gone ahead of Canada. And these are the standings after round five. China back in the lead with a massive 35-point lead over Mexico, who has a 7-point lead over Russia, who has only a 7-point lead over Korea. It's all to play for as we go into the sixth and final round of the men's 10-meter synchro competition. Japanese back in sixth place. First place they got to was fourth. Final dive, forward 3.5 somersaults pike. Well, beautiful entry from both of them. Can't tell which dive had their feet apart going. It was just a flinching moment. So I don't think it'll be good enough for them to move up from sixth place into medal contention. Good effort, though. Yeah, just out of sync on the entry. One diver further ahead than the other, that Otsuka. Head up a little, both of them in the pike. See the gap between the legs and the chest, so could neaten up the pikes a little bit more. But a good effort from the Japanese. And now it's Canada, ready for their dive, currently in fifth. And a good effort for their last dive as well. They were 7 points behind third place going into this round, this final round. I'm not sure the dive's going to be good enough to pick up 7 points, but they certainly give it good effort. 1.5 twist first, pull forward into the pike, floating around from about 5 meters up. Small splash being thrown up, 76.80. Wow, so we'll look at their final score, 373.77. That is within reach of a medal. Mexico. Wow, what a competition the Mexicans have. Flip-flop between first and second. And they're up for a medal. Final dive back, 3.6 degree of difficulty. Oh, and they disappear through the water. Now, it is going to be a medal for Mexico. We don't know what color yet. We still have 3 more teams to go, but they're in second place at the moment before that dive, and they're going to get a big score as well. 2.5 twist, pull forward into the pike, lining up at about 4 meters, get the vertical entry, no wobble on the twist, keep the feet together going from the transition. It's a great final dive for the Mexicans. They deserve a medal, but what color, we're going to have to yet wait. They'll be looking back now. What is that score going to be? Well, we can hear the eights. And they have gone over 400 points. 403.26. 88.56 on that individual dive. Russia in third place. Mexico have just gone 88 points. Russians are finishing the reverse 3.5 somersaults. Oh, it's a huge miss. They are blown out. Now, we are going to see terrible scores here for the Russians. Everything fine at this point, but then the kick. Shoev with the better of the dives, but this kick here, way too early. Dropping shot and with that, could a medal go? They have gone from third back to fifth place. Oh, who would have thought that? Shoev and Vinukov were there for a medal, just needed to land on their head. Final divers of this sixth round is China, currently in the lead, finishing with a back 2.5 somersaults, 1.5 twists. And that is the dive that has won the men's 10-meter synchro competition. China, again, for the fourth time of these championships, pick up their fourth gold medal. It didn't have it all their own way. The Mexicans pushed them at the beginning. But with style and dives like this, it was always going to be hard to beat the Chinese up in the 10-meter, a board that they have specialized in for 30 years. They have produced so many champions, and yet another one goes to the team event here. Keo and Huang take gold for China in style, 80.64 as a final score for them. And they've got a massive 431, so winning by nearly 30 points over Mexico. And they're the final standing. China gold for the fourth time of these championships. Mexico pick up another medal with silver. And Canada has slipped past the Russians after that huge miss by them and take bronze for their first medal of the championships. The final competition of today is our sixth final. It's the mixed 3-meter synchro competition. And there's our lineup today. So the mixed synchro competition, we have Germany going first, followed by China, then Korea, Japan. Then we have Australia, USA, Mexico, Italy, Russia, and Ukraine. China, some of the favorites. China really picked up 4 gold medals. Mexico, 1 gold medal. Beautiful dives from both of them. Jiangqing Wu, she picked up a silver medal in the 1 meter yesterday. So already 1 medal in the bag. Ji Hu, first competition for him. There's the reach, the touch, the slide round the side, then the line up and punch for the water. Synchronization is pretty good. Divers will be looking to try to get above 50 points. Let's see which team is the first to do that. 43 for the Germans, 48.6 for the Chinese. Mexicans have always been strong in this competition. 2017 chance. Zuniga Ornelas had a different partner then. He was partnering with Chavez. She was a great synchro diver. Lovely entry from Mendoza. Again, at this point, it's just about being steady, not making any mistakes, not dropping too much behind. If you can get to 50 points, that's good. That's a bonus. Good pike. I like Carolina's dive there closest to us. She was completely vertical, a little knee safe under the water. And then we just see Zuniga and Alice just going slightly over, 48.60. So that matches exactly the same score as the Koreans and also the Chinese. So there's Neva and Lapin. Beautiful reverse dives from the Russian pair. Selesneva, good timing on the board. She rode the board, was able to get up as high as Lapin. Very high takeoff, beautiful touch. The same come out, hands grabbed in front of the face and then reach back, punch the water. Very tight bodies, good core tension. Russian's doing well. 48.6, so 0.6 more than they had in the round one. I'll be pleased with that. Russia in first. And the 2.5 somersaults pipe. Oh, they both nailed their entry. They really do want a gold medal, don't they? Now, I'm just going to check to see if the toes were close coming past the board. Hard to see on this side. Because I did hear... No, I think we're fine. The judges can mark it down if they think the diver is going to hit the diving board or could hit the board. They can give it a maximum of 2 points. They've got away with it. 66.60. So three divers, three teams so far have got into the 60s. Russian being the third. Same dive for the Chinese. They're currently in second points, 1.8 behind the Russians. It's going to be a big score. Great 3.5s from both of them. Wu was able to keep up with Hu. In fact, he just held back a little bit on his jump. Chanting Wu, nice 3.5 pike here on the right-hand side. See how she grabs right behind the back of the knees. Legs are locked out. No bent knees from either of these Chinese divers. And good vertical entries. The highest score so far has been in the high 60s. Could this be the first dive that gets close to 70 points? It is the first dive into 70, and it's by the Chinese 3.5 somersaults pike. We still have the Ukrainians to go, currently in third place. Oh, beautiful entry there. By Vopishin with his 3.5 pike. Shelly Stook. Now she had a bad takeoff there. Holds into that pike and actually manages to get out. Yeah, her takeoff was poor. Beautiful pike. Nice entry. Another dive that should be in the 60s. So the Ukrainians are doing really well at the moment. 64. So that's their high scoring optional so far. Well, after that drama, let's hope that they're safe and they're okay. China up next, currently in the lead. Well, no problems there at all. We're gonna see a good score. They scored 70 on their 3.5 pike. This, their forward 2.5 of one twist. Performed superbly. There's the throw. Nice transition to the twist, back into the pike, easily locking out, lots of room there. Good synchronization as well. So the highest scores we've seen are 72 points. Would this go higher? No, it's below 69.30. Well, mean old judges there, that definitely deserves 70 points. USA still have a chance of a medal. Big dive here. It's a back 2.5 pike. It's 3.0. They have a chance if they can nail it. And they make up 10 points. Yeah, they've nailed it as well. Well, let's see what the judges give it. It was a good back 2.5. But the others are missing. They're spot on. Reach back, pull forward, spot, out, reach back again. Just a little untidy from O'Brien going through the water. Good synchronization. So they're in fifth place. They're going to have to rely on others to miss. 63.90. So they'll be sitting and waiting to see their final score. 2.6214. So they're ahead of the Koreans at the moment. Next Mexico are in fourth, just a few points ahead of the US, which has scored 63 points. Well, the synchronization was out, but both individual scores were good. Mendoza had a slower spin. Zuniga on Alice. So they're out at different times. Mendoza out later in her twist. Just having a look here. She holds onto the pike longer. So they score 63, the same score as the Americans, and they have gone ahead of USA. Russia currently in second place. And there we see a performance for Russia's first medal of the championships. And it's taken six finals to do it. Good 2.5-1 twist from the pair. Lovely synchronization there. Lining up, hitting the water just about the same time. 60.30. So although they were consistent every dive into the 60s in the optionals, they've just been outclassed by the Chinese in this particular competition. But it's not all over yet. We still have one team left, and that's the Ukrainians, before we get the official score. And the Ukrainians are currently in third, and what a position for them. Could this be Ukraine's first medal of the competition? Back 2.5 somersaults pike. Oh no, and they miss it. They missed the chance of a medal, I am sure. Both of the divers dropped their back 2.5 short, and it was so crucial. They just needed to land on their head to get Ukraine's medal in these championships, but they're too slow on the spin, too slow going into the pike, dropping like a stone, out with the feet dropping to the water, can't pull the dive around. And they get a disastrous 43.2 points. And that has moved from third back to fifth place. Oh, that was an amazing competition. It's always exciting when you get the pairs, especially the mixed pairs. You're never quite sure what's going to happen. And there's the final results. China pick up their fifth gold medal of the competition. Russia pick up their first medal of the competition. And Mexico gain another medal at these championships.